All right, everybody. Over the last few weeks, everyone's been asking if their pranks were still happening. I guess you're about to find out your answer to that. This was a double down kind of prank. He hadn't got me back yet for the first one, so I saw an opportunity and had to go for it. At the beginning of this little run on the tour here, we were getting into Denver, and I found out that morning that Brian was going to be on a later flight. I knew that he had just been home with his kid for the first 2 weeks, and having that happen to me recently, you know, that doesn't offer a lot of sleep, and thought it'd be a good idea to get a key to his room before he got there the next morning. Found it wasn't very hard for me to do.
All right, first things first.
Like to order some wine into my room.
So step one, when we got into his room, I went ahead and ordered two of the most expensive bottles of red wine that I could find on the room service to really set the mood for what was about to happen.
Yeah, I was wondering if I could order a bottle of the Duckhorn Merlot. We'll take two glasses. Thank you so much. Awesome. Thank you, sir. Come on in.
Next one will be an Opus 1 to Brian Hainer's room. I'm not drinking alone, by the way. Synyster Gates. Don't forget your friend Rafa's here.
Just remember that as you're seeing this story unfold. The guy behind the camera was my accomplice the whole time.
I was forced.
So as I'm having my nice fine wine on Synyster's tab, I started to look around and kind of survey the room, the layout.
Where do I begin?
I'm a little bit of an artist when it comes to this, and I wanted to make sure that everything had been thought out. So we started in the bathrooms. I emptied out all the shampoo, conditioner, body wash, so that if he got in there and hadn't had a shower yet, he wasn't going to be able to get one.
Well, he's not conditioning his head that night, nor will he have shower douche.
Dirty, dirty Gates.
I'll put that out first. You can deal with that later.
But then as I'm going through it, I have another idea.
Do you think he uses the robe?
On the off chance that he's a robe guy.
He may want to use his robe. He's got towels here.
You gotta open this bitch up.
I gotta get rid of the lotion anyway. Why don't I put it inside, just in case he goes to grab him.
If he's gonna use it, I don't want him to get a rash.
After I place some lotion nicely inside the robe, into a couple towels.
This is a nice dry towel.
I made sure that I folded them back up so that he wouldn't know until he was already using them what had happened to him.
Ready for action.
I really hope he uses that. I'd fall for that.
Don't forget how much of a dick Gates is. He's got a room with two showers. I mean, come on. Who needs that? What a prima donna.
Ah, this is such an easy one. The one thing a guy always needs is some doo-doo paper.
I did make sure I got all the toilet paper out, so there was no rolls when he went to use the restroom either.
I understand how ungreen this is. I could use so much fucking toilet paper. Who uses this amount of toilet paper to take a shit? This is gonna be quite the bummer. I mean, you're in a hotel. Why wouldn't they have toilet paper right there for you, right? All right.
Bathroom number two.
Where'd I put my wine?
So then, you know, I think about what are the things that I want when I get into a hotel first thing in the morning after a long flight. First of all, I'm going to see all this stuff that's happened in my room and I'm going to go, wow, this sucks. I just need a cup of coffee or something.
I'm stealing these.
No coffee.
So instead, he would find that there was no water in the Nespresso machine. There was no cups to be found anywhere. Another thing that I know about Synyster Gates is that he would have to call down and actually do something for himself and actually call down and get more pods. He doesn't like to do that all the time.
All the chairs have to go in the bathroom.
When I started to make my way into the suite living room, I realized that there was furniture that just shouldn't still be in that room anymore. So I was able to get a couple of roller chairs into the bathtub, finally placed. And then I looked at the shower and I kind of had to contemplate it. And I was like, can we get it in there? So I grabbed another chair with the help of a sweet, sweet cameraman. I was able to get it right into that shower.
That's not bad at all.
And then I found an umbrella in the closet. I wanted to open it up into one of the showers.
Ah, you fuck. Am I even close?
Well, it's awkward. You're close, but...
I thought it was going to be an easier task, so, you know, given my stature, I again needed a little bit of help.
Trusty stick.
Never open it.
That's fine.
Feeling pretty good about this. That is a piece of art over there. That's like straight up fucking Hunter S. Thompson shit right there.
And the bathroom's pretty staged at this point. I'm feeling pretty good about it.
Loosening up bulbs.
Yes.
Notice a lot of paintings on the wall as there usually are in these rooms, and I was just testing their durability, you know, seeing which ones I could possibly get off.
Boom. You're done.
So that was supposed to be still on there.
But when I only had one to work with, I had to set it aside.
This is gonna be a coup de grace. Actually, that's not even how you say it. But this is gonna be the piece of resistance. I'll find a place for this at the end of the day.
Another part of this was the bed, the mattress.
I'm plagued with the question, what do I do to the bed?
How do I fuck with this bed without fucking peeing on it? Mattress against the wall, picture where the mattress used to be.
And with a little help from my friend, we were able to pull the mattress off the bed and find a giant curtain covering a window that I was able to hide it behind.
So it looked like I'm hiding something or what?
Come to find out the next day, I was pretty successful because our dear security guards that were helping him put the room back together were really trying to figure out where that mattress went. So we're here pretty much at the end, and you know, there's just the last couple little pieces to the painting that I wanted to get out there.
Get as cold as possible. What time is it?
How long can we do the 24-hour porn? I gotta start the porn before I fucking leave the room.
Turned it up real loud and took both the remotes from the room, put them in my pocket, they were coming with me. And then I found my placement for the painting so that he knew who it was that pulled off this wonderful piece of art for him.
I'm gonna fucking toilet paper the inside of that room.
We just gotta go back and forth, mummy style. Shit.
That was also a bit of a piece of art. We started in the furthest corner from the door and toilet papered our way out.
Alright. I think we're ready.
So yes, I had made my piece of art and I had doubled down. I knew exactly what I was doing when I did it, but I had to seize the opportunity because I knew he's still gonna have to get me back from the chipmunk one. And instead of just letting it ride, I had to make sure that I was gonna get another opportunity and get my stabs in when I can. Which, by the way, by the time you see this video, he has gotten me back one little way, but he didn't have the cameras on. So, you know, you're gonna have to pull that up with him.
So what really bugs you right now?
What bugs me? My hotel room bugs me right now. It's in shambles. I showed up today and my room was trashed. Johnny Christ drank 2.5 bottles of wine in my room with this guy. Yeah, and my mattress was hidden. How do you hide a mattress?
I don't know. Yeah. Wow, that's crazy. It sounds anyway, like you have
sorry.
Fun. Well, then I'll...
I don't have fun. They have fun.
Oh.
And it begins. Day one. Day one, ladies and gentlemen.
Tell them, not possible.
Why'd you open this one, though?
What was
the theory on that?
Just because when he walks in, he's going to be very weirded out by the fact that there's an open cot with a fucking dick and balls sitting there.
Honey, he's laughing, and I'm like, what the fuck? Johnny's not even on this floor. And I laid in my bed. Couple more minutes, then I heard the wine bottle pop, and I'm like, what the fuck is happening right now? And so I started pounding on the door, and I'm just like, fucking John.
It's all out of love, bro. Yes, I'm going to love you too.